The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty Father, whose dear Son, on the night before he suffered, instituted the sacrament of his body and blood, mercifully grant that we may receive it thankfully, in remembrance of Jesus Christ our Lord, who in these mysteries gives us the pledge of eternal life, and who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus, beginning in the first verse of the 12th chapter. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall mark for you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year for you. Tell the whole congregation of Israel that on the 10th of this month they are to take a lamb for each family, a lamb for each household. If a household is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join its closest neighbor in obtaining one. The lamb shall be divided in proportion to the number of people who eat it. Your lamb shall be without blemish, a year old male. You may take it from the sheep or from the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of this month. Then the whole assembled congregation of Israel shall slaughter it at twilight. They shall take some of the blood and put it on the two doorposts and the lintel of the houses in which they eat it. They shall eat the lamb that same night. They shall eat it roasted over the fire with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. Do not eat any of it raw or boiled in water, but roast it over the fire, with its head, legs, and inner organs. You shall let none of it remain until the morning. Anything that remains until the morning you shall burn. This is how you shall eat it: your loins girded, your sandals on your feet, and your staff in your hand, and you shall eat it hurriedly. It is the Passover of the Lord. For I will pass through the land of Egypt that night, and I will strike down every firstborn in the land of Egypt, both human beings and animals. On all the gods of Egypt I will execute judgments. I am the Lord. The blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you live. When I see the blood, I will pass over you, and no plague shall destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt. This day shall be a day of remembrance for you. You shall celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. Throughout your generations, you shall observe it as a perpetual ordinance." The word of the Lord.
I love the Lord because he has heard the voice of my supplication.
Because he has inclined his ear to me whenever I call upon him.
How shall I repay the Lord? I will lift up the cup of salvation
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people.
Precious in the sight of the Lord
is the death of his servant.
O Lord, I am your servant.
I am your servant and the child of your handmaid. You have redeemed my bonds.
I will offer you the sacrifice of thanksgiving
and call upon the name of the Lord.
I will fulfill my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people,
in the courts of the Lord's house,
in the midst of you, O Jerusalem.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put it into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hands, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wash them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but also my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, he put on his robe and returned to the table. He said to them, "Do you not know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for that is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example, that you also should do as I have done to you. Very truly I tell you, servants are not greater than their master, nor are messengers greater than one who sent him. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself, and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Good evening. I bring you greetings from Bishop Taylor, Bishop Bruce, and all of our diocesan staff, and also gratitude for your prayers. Please know that you are in our prayers as well. My name is Melissa, and I'm very happy to be here with you this evening celebrating this beautiful liturgy of Maundy Thursday. Maundy Thursday is one of my favorite liturgies of the church year. It is so rich in meaning, in symbolism, and in relationship. There are lots of different ways that you can look at Maundy Thursday, so many depths that can be plumbed. However, in this year, in 2020, Maundy Thursday is unique. It is the second Maundy Thursday that we have celebrated during the pandemic. Instead of being together, seeing one another eye to eye, standing with one another to receive the Eucharist, the last Eucharistic feast before Good Friday, we are instead in our homes, watching with others in their homes. It is a strange time and a strange way to celebrate a liturgy that establishes a template for how we are to relate with one another as members of Christ's body. In our gospel reading this evening, Jesus tells us that he's giving us a new commandment. The word mandi, by the way, comes from the Latin mandatum, which means command. So Jesus is giving us a new commandment to love one another as he has loved us. Now, I think of John's gospel as the sacramental gospel, because so much of what happens in this gospel is an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace that Jesus is teaching us about. So the gospel for this Maundy Thursday is a great example of this. Jesus is showing the outward and visible sign of this new commandment in making himself servant of all by taking off the outer layer of his clothing, wrapping a towel around his waist like a servant, and washing the feet of his disciples. He tells them, and he's also telling us, that we should do just as he does. Just as Jesus has loved them, so we should love one another. And did you notice Peter's reaction? First, Peter was resistant. Lord, you cannot wash my feet. And then Jesus tells him that if he doesn't wash his feet, Peter will have no share with him. So Peter says, okay, then my hands and my head also. And Jesus responds, if you have bathed recently, only your feet need washing. And Jesus tells them that they are all clean, all but one of them. There are two things happening here. First, it is a setup for Jesus to say that not everyone is clean, which means he's telling them he knows that someone has betrayed him. But the other thing that is happening here is Peter is being Peter. In his enthusiasm and his desire to get it right, he is working hard to control the situation. He is trying to control the way that Jesus shows this outward and visible sign of the inward and spiritual grace of his love. And that's the thing about love. It is not something we can control. So often when we preach on Maundy Thursday, we talk about what it means to love one another, and that's important. We talk about the humility of being a servant. That is also important. We talk about loving each other in the way that Jesus has shown his love for us. That is also important. But rarely do we talk about what it means to receive that love. This Maundy Thursday, as we remain in our homes, separated from our worshiping communities, I think it's a good time to focus on what it means to receive this love of Christ. Receiving love really means giving up our control. It means letting someone else take care of us. And I suspect we are all a little bit like Peter. I know that I am a lot like Peter, especially during this pandemic time. I find I want to control more in my life, especially when everything else is so out of control and unpredictable. But it really is a spiritual practice to allow someone else to love us and to allow God to love us and to give up the control we desire in that. It is a spiritual practice to give up that control. God's love for us all is not something we control, and it is definitely not something that we can earn. There is nothing we can do to get more love or less love. God's love is something that is simply offered in its fullness, and it is infinite. God's love is not a transaction. It is a way that we have of living our lives in love. It is closer to us than the air we breathe. Receiving God's love is as simple as opening ourselves up to God's love. It is simple, but it is not always easy. On this Maundy Thursday, as we begin the great 3 days of our Lord's Passion, I invite you to join with me in asking less of yourself, not more. I invite you to join with me in opening yourself to God's love, to letting go of control, and simply receiving what is being offered. The thing about receiving love is that love never ends with us. God's love received becomes God's love given. Beloved, let us receive God's infinite love this evening and throughout these great 3 days. And let us love one another as Christ has loved us. There is no greater witness of the power of the love and grace of God than love received and given in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Fellow servants of our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night before his death, Jesus set an example for his disciples by washing their feet, an act of humble service. He taught that strength and growth in the life of the kingdom of God come not by power, authority, or even miracle, but by such lowly service. This year, once again, we best love and serve one another by remaining physically distant, looking forward to that day when we will again follow our Lord's washing of each other's feet. On this holy night, we may still engage in acts of servant love with those around us. Therefore, I invite us all who share in the royal priesthood of Christ to recall those servants we are by following the example of our Master. Find some means this night or in the next holy days to love your neighbor in an act of service. Remember his admonition, a servant is not greater than his master, nor is one who is sent greater than the one who sent him. If you know these things, blessed are you that do them.
Thank you. Dear friends in Christ, as we gather for worship this evening, we bring with us the day's cares and concerns. I now invite you to offer to God those things which give joy to or burden your heart. For whom shall we pray?
We offer thanksgiving for Mother Melissa McCarthy, our preacher this evening, and for her ministry in the Diocese of Los Angeles. We pray for our bishops, John and Diane.
We pray for all the sick of this parish community, for all those who continue to be sick with COVID-19. We pray for all the thousands who have died.
We pray for the city of Los Angeles as it struggles to find a just way to care for our homeless brothers and sisters. We offer thanksgiving for all those whom the last year have brought evening prayer to this congregation through Facebook Live.
We pray for our president and vice president and all who hold the authority of government, that they might make wise decisions in these days.
We offer thanksgiving for the work of our food pantry, and for all the volunteers who work so hard to feed our hungry neighbors.
For all Christians who are beginning these holy days this night, and for all who are preparing for holy baptism throughout the church.
Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us that what we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we also do for you. Give us the will to be servants of others, as you were servant of all who gave up his life and died for us. And now you live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For our sins he was lifted high upon the cross, that he might draw the whole world to himself. And by his suffering and death, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who put their trust in him. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
We praise you, O God, Savior of the world, for you made all humankind in your image, to rule your creation in peace, and commanded us to live together in love forever. When our first parents disobeyed you, turned away and hid their faces from you, you sought them in the cool of the evening. Though they wandered far away from the tree of life that you gave them, you never ceased to search for us, their children. With the same steadfast love, you led your people Israel out of slavery, and when they had deserted you and worshipped false gods, still you did not forsake them. You gave them your law to guide them, and you led them through the desert to a new land of promise. In due time, you sent your Son himself to seek out the lost and bring them the good news of your boundless mercy. He did not keep himself to the company of the righteous. He chose sinners for his friends, and laying before them your gift of forgiveness, he died for them on the tree of the cross, showing the fullness of love. Then you raised him from the dead and poured out your Spirit on all humankind. When he opened again the gates of paradise, Adam and Eve rejoiced as he pulled them from the grave. Now he shares his victory with those who rejected him. Now we sinners too rejoice to give thanks for the death and risen life of your Son. And in the power of his Spirit, we have turned from our errors to follow his example and share his saving life in the breaking of the bread. For on the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new commandment, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, eternal God, from all the things that are yours, we offer you these, which are yours especially. We offer them gladly, as he told us, giving thanks for his death and resurrection, and seeing that the power of sin is broken and Christ is all in all, we praise you and we bless you.
We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, O Lord our God.
Now send your sanctifying Spirit to show us that this bread and this cup are the body and blood of your Son, and that every sin is pardoned and every debt is redeemed, and you have made us your holy people. And in union with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Holy Mother of God, St. John, patron of this cathedral church, and all your saints, bring us at last to his kingdom of peace.
By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast.
For those who cannot receive our Lord physically in the sacrament this evening, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you now sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that in this wonderful sacrament you have given us the memorial of your passion. Grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may know within ourselves and show forth in our lives the fruit of your redemption. For you are alive and reign now and forever. Amen.
Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name, blessed be the Jesus Christ, true God and true man, blessed be the name of Jesus, blessed be his most sacred heart, blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar, blessed be God, the Holy Ghost, the Comforter, blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy, blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Thank you.